So why would you want to use a green screen specifically in a Zoom meeting? So Zoom has virtual backgrounds, but there's an option that you can check for specifically using a green screen. And that's what we're going to talk about in this video. I'm Brighton West, and I'm a virtual videographer who helps coaches use online video, and I spend a lot of my day on Zoom. And I see a lot of virtual backgrounds, and I see a lot of virtual background problems that can be solved by adding a green screen. So we're going to talk about those today in this video. So this is the background of my office today that I may not want to share. I'm doing this actually special for you guys. Normally, I have a different camera that looks out my window and has a beautiful background, but if you shift a little bit, this is really what the rest of my office looks like. I added a little extra clutter just for this video, just for you. I tell my clients that the best thing is to have a nice background, a nice natural background, because it helps to create a connection with the person on the other side of the camera versus a virtual background, which might be something that's a little bit generic. If you have a spot that you can really set up in your office to kind of share your space, you have a bookshelf, things like that, that is the best setup. But next best setup is a virtual background. And I would say that's a virtual background that's somehow personalized, not one that's just one of the off-the-shelf ones from Zoom. So let me show you here, just putting myself onto a virtual background now. So I'm gonna go over into Zoom and next to the stop video or the video camera, click that up, and I am going to choose a virtual background. So you can see here, I can choose any virtual background, and that looks pretty good. So let's just use this one. You can also do some video backgrounds. So let's start here, actually. One of the things is that some people, if your computer is older, you can't do virtual backgrounds without a green screen. It just won't let you because your computer can't process things. So if you are not able to access this, if it just doesn't work, if it says, sorry, your computer is too old, you can click, I have a green screen, and it will probably work because it's much less processor intensive if you have the green screen. So your computer doesn't work as hard, plus you get better results. And for some of you, that might be a necessity. So I just wanted to mention that if you aren't seeing this. For some computers, you can actually do video backgrounds. So you've got movement back there if you've got a newer computer. But let's just go ahead and take one of the traditional backgrounds. This is something that comes with Zoom, and we'll talk about this. Let me close this out. So this is now set here. But if it's not perfect, so it understands where your face is and maybe where your hands are, but sometimes you end up with like little pieces of your hands missing or little areas in between showing up. If you go ahead and you take a mug here and you try to take a drink, you know, it kind of comes and goes. If you're sharing something, if you're like, oh, I want to share this piece of paper here, this piece of paper, it has to recognize it as your face, otherwise it thinks it's part of the background. So that's part of the system. And if you're someone who likes to use a headset when you're on a Zoom call, you can see that it just makes some weird things happen with the edges of your head when you have a headset on, when it can't understand quite what's going on. If you've got dangling earrings, I've seen them kind of come and go in a video. So those are some things you might want to avoid or add the actual green screen. And this is a very cool system, Zoom, but it's not perfect. So this is probably the biggest thing that having a green screen behind you will solve. So let's go ahead and set up a green screen and show you how this works out. So I am going to set up a green screen from Get Around. You can get these over on Amazon, and I'll have a link down below if you want to buy that. It's an affiliate link, so you support my channel if you do that. But this is a good option. It's very portable and very quick. Really, if you're going to be in your office doing this often, what I would suggest is a green screen that is either pulling up from the floor or pulling down from the ceiling. I'll have links down below too for some options there. But you want to get one that's wider than tall. A lot of them are set up for photographers and not for video like this. Your screen is typically wider than tall, so make sure that you get one that stretches that direction, not this direction. But let me pop out the Get Around. So the Get Around comes in a little bag like this, so it's pretty portable. And you open it up. This is kind of it springs. So watch out, my dog hates it when I do this. Into a pretty big screen, and then it mounts on the back of your chair. So let me just kind of show you that here. There we go. Instant green screen, almost instant. So then just, you know, kind of work it in so that you can see that it's completely green behind you. Like I said, this might be easier with a different type of green screen, but this one is great because it's it folds up and gets put away and kind of hides away in the corner. It's a little tricky to fold up, but there's lots of videos on YouTube to help you with that. So let me show you now what it looks like when you click the green screen button. So head on down to that little arrow again, choose a virtual background. We'll choose the same virtual background and we'll click I have a green screen. So now close this out and pretty much the same. I'm not seeing much difference until I pick up that cup of coffee and I try to have a drink. So look, I'm almost out. Actually, I drink tea. I'm almost out of tea, but you can see this no problem. You want to hold up that report or something. You got the latest invention that you want to share with your boss. This works great. So it solves that problem. And you can see here, if you're someone who likes to wear a headset when you're on your calls, that looks completely normal when you're on an actual green screen. If your computer is older, it's gonna allow you to have a virtual background. The downside here is that you wanna make sure that your screen completely covers what your camera covers. So if I turn my chair too much, you can see here that the corners of the green screen are no longer at the corners of the screen and you have your background. So when using a green screen, you have to make sure that you do have those corners covered, and especially if using one that's attached to your chair, you need to make sure that you don't move your chair too much while you're talking. One last thing I feel like I have to add here as kind of a full disclosure is that I did have to do some modifications to my webcam on my iMac to make the web around work. So let me switch back with before I did those modifications. And I turn on the camera that is built in, my FaceTime camera on my iMac. You can see here that it's just a little bit, I have to get myself in really close, and then my nose starts to look big and my head, my forehead starts to look big. So I used a software called eyeglasses on my iMac to make that work. And you can see here when I choose eyeglasses, this software allows you to zoom in. It allows you to do a number of different things on your computer. Let me just pull this up. So here is eyeglasses. It allows you to modify any webcam on your computer. You can zoom in so that you get a little bit closer without physically getting close to your computer. It just feels weird and it starts to make you look a little weird too. And plus there's other types of things, you know, adjustments of the color and the temperature and all that kind of good stuff is built into the eyeglasses software. I just wanted to mention that because I didn't want you to go out to have an iMac to buy the web around and then realize that it doesn't work without a little bit of an extra tweak. So I've got a video about that too. There'll be a link up here if you want to check out the video about the eyeglasses software to modify the webcam on your Mac. And the green screen needs to be somewhat decently evenly lit. Zoom does a pretty good job if it's not even compared to some of the other softwares out there that really want a really even lighting across the green screen. And there is one more potential problem with your green screen. And that problem is that you cannot wear the color green. Otherwise, it'll disappear into the background, whereas a regular virtual background without a green screen, let me just set that up real quick, switch it over, switch over. Now you can see that my green shirt shows up without a problem. If I'm doing the virtual background, no green screen. So now that you know how to get rid of this background and how to look great on your call, I've got another video for you over here, and that is about how to look your client or the person on the other side directly in the eyes instead of like on a typical call. It looks like you're kind of looking like this. This is a great system that I've come up with, uses a one-way mirror, and it is wonderful. It makes it so easy to do Zoom calls. I want you to check that out next. I'll see you over in that video.